Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We got Kevin Peterson breaking the balls. He'll go to six. Ozzy goes to seven. Playing eight ball, Ozzy Reynolds. And Kevin Peterson. Kevin Peterson hails from Oro Valley, Arizona. He's a police officer there. Ozzy originally is from Eastern Shore, Virginia, and he's actually heading up this operation you've seen here, but he's also playing in his own tournament. So, he's a master player. Kevin is an advanced player in BCA. I believe he's a 677 on the Fargo rating system, and Kevin is about a 642. So they're pretty close, and that one race, that one game, is the perfect match for them, according to Fargo. So we'll see how this goes. Ozzy is a 64.5% odds of him winning are 64.5% as opposed to 35.5% for Kevin. Now I'll tell you right now, Ozzy's going to have to play well because Kevin's been playing very well in Tucson. This is the first time I've seen Ozzy play. I haven't seen Kevin play in some time. He's played on a couple of the Diamond Pool Tour events, and he's done well, but I haven't seen him play. Well, everything's open for him. He's got to convert here. He's got to pocket this three ball in the corner. Bump the 13, he's not going to bump it. Yeah, he bumps the 13, he gets on to 5, and then he comes down for these two balls down here. There you go. Bring it straight back, or halfway down on the right for the 6 ball in the left-hand corner pocket. Perfect. Now just follow this down for the 2 ball. And then, depending on the angle he gets on the 2 ball, well, he's gonna stun over for it, excuse me. Not too far. He had to come up for this 8. He went to the same pocket, okay. And looks like Ozzy's gonna take the first game for a 1-0 lead. And Kevin will trail by a game. Kevin walked up as his partner Steve Peterman has his phone and is watching the live stream, and he saw the percentages next to his name, and he walks up and says, "Does this mean I only have a 35% chance of winning?" You just went to 26. We're having some fun here. He wants to know why he only has a 26% chance of winning now. That's according to the rating system. These are the same odds you see when it's when they flash the poker players flash the odds after getting this card and that card. But keep in mind, there's always the river card that changes everything. And that's why they call it gambling. Or other cards as they come along. And with pool, there's always the unforced errors. There's always the bad roll. There's always a little table roll-off, possibly. Although you don't see much of it on these diamond seven-footers. But, or a mental lapse, or, you know, we're human. We're human. Statistics are one thing. Human emotion, human frailties, human strengths are made, or have been shown to overcome. That's a percentage. One, zero. So basically we have a straight up race of six. And if he takes solids, everything's open. Everything's open. It should. He's going to play the combo for the solid. Did he get down on top of that ball, or can he see the next one? Can he see that seven? If you can see the seven, I'm going to predict a run out. It looks like he can. He's going to cut this ball in the lower left-hand corner pocket, and that one ball is going to hit one rail into the nine, probably. Or miss the nine completely, and set up for perfect position to almost ensure the run out. Ozzy Reynolds with CSI, general manager for CSI. Taking Kevin Peterson, a police officer from Oro Valley, to school. The first two racks. He's telling Kevin, get real comfortable in that chair, because you're down 2-0. And see how you like your percentage now. And Kevin says, it's my break. Let's see how you like your percentage after I break and run. That's what's going through his mind. And we'll see what actually happens. Let's see if he likes his percentage when he sees what's about to come on the screen. See what Kevin thinks about being at 18%. Chances of winning are 18% according to the Fargo rate. Well, the chances probably just went down a little bit more after jumping the cue ball off the table. Ozzy gets ball in hand, and they're broken wide open. This could easily, probably, be another table run. Let's see what he takes. They both look good. Solids and stripes both look good. There's one less solid to pocket, so if that's a consideration, it works. The solids go well down here in this corner pocket. You can start out with the five, bring it back a little bit, play the seven in the same pocket. Bring it back a little bit, play the four, play the inside left side, the six in the opposite side pocket. He could start with his two ball. It's the only problem ball. It's the only problem ball he has. It's the two. If he takes solids, it looks like he's going to take stripes. Oh, he's got the 10. Nice pattern he's picked out. Very nice pattern. The stem ball leads him down for the 9 in the corner. He'll come up for the 12 on the opposite. Oh, they both go to the same corner. I think he wanted to come down that far. Yeah. Had he given himself an angle to come down, he'd be able to shoot the 9 ball, then the 12. This is a good shot. Make this and just bump the 8. Bump it straight up. Or miss the 8 and come over to where his hand is. He can hit the cue ball where his hand is. He can follow the 10 ball down for. Now you want less angle. Because I was thinking he could, with less angle, if he had more angle, he could draw the cue ball to the upper right hand corner, 2 rails, and come down for this 12. Looks like he might be able to draw straight back. I'm just going to stop it and cut it in. It says I don't have to get perfect on it. I can handle this. And handle it he did. 3 runs in a row. Frazzy. Kevin got the break. 3-0. Let's see where his chances go now. See how he likes his chances. Okay, we're back. A little sponsorship commercial. Nice, lively commercial for Casino del Sol, where we're having the Tucson warm-ups in preparation for the 39th annual BCAPL National Championships. Las Vegas at the Rio. And there goes the 6. There goes the 13. There goes the... Never mind. The 4 ball does not go. One of each, open table. The solids are... If he chooses stripes, he's got a ball to contend with on the left-hand rail. The 9 ball. That's the only problem he has, and the 8 ball. He has to move those. If he chooses solids... He's going to have to maneuver. Let's see what his choices are here. I think he's going to go with the solids. And he might start. I don't know that I would shoot that 9 into the 4. I think I would leave that there. Shoot that 3 in the side, going 2 rails. No. He's got a little bit, not much of a problem with the 1-7 in the middle of the table. The 1 goes to where the 4 is. So, that 5 ball will go to the upper left-hand corner. It won't come down because the 9 ball is in the way. If he removes the 9 ball, pretty much open to run out. He doesn't have any limitations. It's called the 4. I'm just going to stop it there. Probably for the 3 in the side. He didn't stop it there. He came back. Did he get a shot on the 2 in the corner? Does it go? Let's see how he navigates this 1-7. I believe the 9 ball has stopped and does not have a shot at the... He's looking at it now. It's tight. He gave it a second look, so it's tight. You have to address... The 5 ball goes up there anyway. Yeah, opened it up. He's played 8 ball before. Yeah. Not real hard, I don't think. Just wants to... Oh, we left it out. Left it out. Well, Kevin finally has a shot. Better take advantage. He's down 3-0 on the race to 6 for him, 7 for his opponent. Opponent needs 4 games, he needs 6. He's trailing by 2 games. Everything's wide open for Kevin. I look for him to run out the sack. Is he? I'm not sure what he's really looking at. The 9 ball goes. He's just looking at what he can make, what kind of damage he can do from that side. And he's got an easy combo. Well, maybe not so easy. The 12 ball is off the rail a little bit. Missed it. Missed it straight in. Ouch. He's in a little bit of a pickle. He's got it. He's playing the 7 ball. I don't think the 1 ball goes in the side pocket past the 7. I like just pocketing this 5 ball and coming down and getting on the 7th to play it in the corner, upper corner pocket. And I think that's what he was looking at, was where he wanted to be, and he got perfect. I'll follow this up a little bit. Softly. Play the 1 ball in probably the left-hand corner. Will it be before or after he plays the deuce? About the same degree of difficulty making the ball, but his shape for the from the one to the two, he has to travel the cue ball more than he does from the two to the one. This is just a little inside English. He doesn't have a full pocket. That ball, that nine ball sticks out a little bit. Sticks out just a hair. And he wants to travel the cue ball to the right side of the table with natural English. Maybe a little hold up, a little inside. He's changing his mind. When I'm playing, that's dangerous because I'm usually undecided when I get down to shoot. But you want to make all your decisions before you step to the position you just did. In the box to shoot, you got to make up your mind. Once you get down to the ball, you don't want to be thinking, should I? That thinking's done with. Doing a good job of making sure he's thought it out exactly how he wants to. Pocket the ball, and 4-0 lead. Huge error by Kevin missing that ball. Huge error. Kevin's not going to like his numbers now. He's down at 5.5%. He needs to win 6 games to his opponent's 3. And you have a master player versus an advanced player. Not looking so relaxed and comfortable anymore. He's sitting there, how could I miss that straight in shot? Well, the more important question is, how am I going to get to the table? And when I get to the table, I must do damage. Meanwhile, how do I limit my liability here when I'm in the chair? So one thing about pool, when you're in the chair, there is nothing you can do. Well, there isn't supposed to be anything you can do. Some guys will sit there and fidget and move around, especially at this angle where Ozzy's facing them, and to move around to distract them, but Kevin won't do that. Most decent players won't do that. But there are people in pool that will do that, unfortunately. Heavily frowned upon in the community, but it does happen. Usually when there's gambling involved. It seems to dirty up the sport a little bit. It's got to be disheartening to have your partner sit down next to you and show you these Fargo ratings. I don't think I want to see those. Or maybe you do want to see those because, you know, that might fire me up to sit there and want to overcome. I've got a 5.5% chance of winning this match. Really? Watch me. Some people, it'll fire up. Some people, it'll break down. Might break them down. open up this ball and the five, I believe. Oh. Yeah, he was not happy with that. I think he can pocket. Yeah, he can pocket the six, the seven ball there. But what do you do with the five? What do you do with the five? Now, Steven, what do you do with the five ball here? What to do? What to do? He's also concerned about possibly catching a kiss off that five and making the eight. So he's thinking about playing the five ball off the 11. Hmm. Interesting. A little too much. Well, if Kevin put the cue ball over by the six ball after shooting this 10 ball, he can run all three balls to the same pocket, pretend he's playing one pocket. But first error by Ozzy. And that's not really an error, that's just a miss. Played a shot off of the ball. You don't have to make those every time. Okay, I'm gonna play this 10 ball on the side. I'll put straight following. I would try to get to the left side of those three balls. Just like that. Come on over. And there you are. Now run all three of them. I think the nine ball go by the one, so the run out is available. But after missing that shot he missed, we'll see if he comes back with a good shot. He's gone up a little bit too far. At least come up a little bit too far. Plan B. I'd be switching to Plan B here. 14 in the side. Left-hand English. Hmm. Perfect. Came down too far. If he was thinking about getting on that 13, I mean on the 11. Came down too far. Now he's going to have to depend on pocketing the 12 and then draw him down from the 9. Or he could go 3 rail. Well, no, he doesn't have it. He's got to shoot the 9 ball soft because it is hindered by the 1. So he has to cheat the pocket. He's going to want to go back and forth. Pocket the 9 and go back and forth and stay high so he can travel the cue ball down for the position on the 11. Or he can always just play position on it right there, go right across the side pocket, wrist scratching, and hit it perfect. So he wants to play the 12 ball off the 8 because it's on the rail, huh? Hmm. Interesting. To decided on a couple of different things here. How hard will he hit this? He's got to have position. See how he's shaking his head, saying, okay. Now he's got to work real hard, double hard, to open those up. Well, in this position, tell you what, I'm going to shoot that 14 ball to the left-hand corner pocket with quite a bit of left English to go up to the rail and back down again, try to get that 8. Crazy as can be, but you know something? I like it better than this bank shot that he's shooting. He'll cheat the pocket and make it. Good shot. Maybe I should like the bank shot better. Interesting. He's on the board. On the board. Problem is, it's an alternate break format. And Ozzy has broken run out twice, I believe. And leads 4-1. Well, we get some percentages back. Break. Ball's available. Shot's available. I think he's taking stripes and saying good night. He never chooses anything with any pace. Nice and soft. Complete control. As most master players do when they're playing on 7-foot diamonds. Never have to hit it hard. You can trust the roll. It's not going to really roll off. Yes, they bank a little shorter than other tables, but get used to it. They're consistent. Learn it. Live it. Love it. He'll stun us to the side and come back out for the 10. He'll stun this up towards the side pocket. And for the 14. And then he'll stun this to the left for the 8 ball in the side pocket on the right. Sweet, simple. Makes it look easy. Came down a little too far. Shouldn't make any difference. For a 5-1 lead. It'll break to the right on this putt. And there it is. 5-1. Ozzy Reynolds over Kevin Peterson. Ozzy needs 2 games to get the 7. Kevin needs 5 games to get the 6 to win this match. He is now at a 4.5% chance of winning this match. He's feeling some desperation now. I've got to do something. I've got to break and run. I've got to break and run. I've got to control. Side rack break. Second ball break. Open. Completely open. And I think we'll see Ozzy take solids. If he has an opening shot, will he take solids? I think so. They seem to be completely open. Maybe not, because this opening shot, there isn't much of one. Trying to wonder what that roar was. Somebody got excited. Yeah. I think he shoots the 3 ball, follows it to the head rail and back for position on the 6. Unless this ball goes by, I don't think it does. Although, I can't tell. Will it go by that one? If it does, it's history. 1, 2. Where's the 7th ball? That must be pretty tight for that 3 ball. Must not go. He's going to take stripes. Only complication might come in with that combination on the head rail. That right now, or he may not, because following to the right side with the 12, it's going to require a little bit of English, and if he clips that 14, he could just go right in the drink. Came straight across over. Okay. I thought that was straight across with that ball, and he would bump it. It was, so he had to go under it. Bumping balls, he got away with that bump. Didn't want to bump that ball. He'll stun this straight across and probably play the 11 ball in the left-hand side. Straight stun. Just dead center English and come over to the right, to his left. Don't run into it. There you go, right where he just pointed his cue. That's where you want to be. He's in beast mode right now. That's trouble. Lots and lots of trouble. Lots and lots of trouble. Can you recover? You know something? You might just kick it in. Actually, it banks in too, so either one. He's got the nice angle to bank it. Cue ball hits the four ball and stops for eight, for the eight. Although he's more concerned with making the ball than anything else. His main concern, he's got to make this ball. He doesn't want Kevin to come to the table. He wants to have a 6-1 lead. Made the ball, went two rails and scratched. Where'd the cue ball go? In the side? So I went went one rail and came down and scratched? Yeah. Ouch. He was trying to come around for it. So he drew away from it. He drew away from the four ball to make that bank shot. I thought he'd run into the four, but I was mistaken. Looks like he drew away from it. Well, Kevin's going to try to change that 4.5% to a little higher number and get two games. He'll still need four, while his opponent needs two. But a mistake here would be deadly, fatal, ugly. Pretty open rack. And under most circumstances, Kevin gets out. In most probability, Kevin gets out. Ozzy made a nice shot on that bank shot. Unexpected. I mean, wow, it's just a bad roll. Go right into that side pocket. So stop it for the four on the side, and we're done. Could have an earthquake, but it'll be 2-5. Doesn't go automatic. Kevin keeps saying. He's kind of getting a kick out of that Fargo rating with the percentages. But I'd be more concerned with focusing on my game. It's just a way to relieve a little pressure, calm the nerves a little. Kevin trails 2-5. Open table. Dry break by Ozzy. He's got a shot on the four in the side. No, he doesn't. The three ball's in the way. He's got a combo 14 deuce to take solids. He might have a shot on the one ball in the corner. He He's going to call the nine ball on the side off the one. Made the combo, so now he's got stripes. Only shot, he's got the 11 or the 13. He's banking the 12. Okay. Well, now he's got the 11 or the 11. Percentage is getting lower right here because, well, he can draw the ball a little bit. Stick it for the 12. Or is it the 14? It's the 14 on the side rail. I should stop trying to guess the 12 and the 14 and just say that ball by the rail, the ball by the in the middle. Well, he wants to open these balls up because they're trouble, so he's going to cut the 13 in. He's over a ball, low percentage. This is interesting. He's a little bit of a dilemma. He can see this, huh? I don't think he can make this ball. I think the seven ball on the rail there stops him. I think his only shot is the 11 or the 13. The 13 is extremely difficult because he's over a ball. So I'm playing the 11 and stopping it dead right there, coming across and hitting the 4 after I shoot the 14. And irrelevant. Makes no difference what I might have done from that location because it's not there anymore. It's been an effective safety. Let's see what Ozzy's options are here. He can play the 10 ball. Cut it in, come down. Oops, I mean, he's got stripes. Solids, I'm sorry. He's made it 3. He's going to bank the 7 in the side. Get it out of the way. There's no doubt. Come up for the 4, then the 5-1, or the 4, then the 6 on the left side, and the 5-1, then the 8. Connect the dots here. Ozzy's liking it. Shoot the 5 ball, get on the 6. Either shot. He'll use a little bit of left angle. Should come down towards the side pocket on the left for position on the 6. Just like that. Little stun, pocket the ball, come out, straight in on the 8, and it's a 6-1, 6-2 lead. is 6-2. Kevin gives him the game. Got Kevin breaking the balls here, trailing 2-6. He says, hooray, hooray, I made a ball on the break. It is frustrating when you're breaking the balls and you can't make a ball on the break and your opponent's making balls on the break and running out. It can drive you to drinking. That's why I bring my own tequila. Teasing. He's dug himself a big hole. Ozzy needs one game. This is a alternate break format, so he's just broke. He wins this, it'll be 3-6. Ozzy breaks, break and run out, wins in the match. If he doesn't, and turns it over, and Kevin runs out, score is 4-6. It'll be Kevin's break. He breaks and runs out. It'll be 5-6. Ozzy will break again. So you'll have, Ozzy will have at least, at worst, 2 breaks for a break and run out to win the match. Meanwhile, Kevin is looking at running out these solids. Looks like he's calling the 5-ball and tying up 2 ball and tie up the 6-ball. I mean the 11-ball goes. 3-ball in the side pocket. Got to find a way to shoot this 2-ball. I suggest shooting it now. If the 4-ball goes in the corner, hit this ball with a little draw. Push the 2-ball over past the 8. You have a shot on the 3. Take care of business. It does. Move the 2-ball right here. Just like that. But he came down too far. He does not have a shot on the 3. Now he's in real trouble. He's going to have to cut the 1-ball up in the corner. Well, looks like he may want to bank the 3. I don't think he can make it in the side. Can't see enough of it. Must be able to see it in the side. Answers that question. I didn't think you could see, you'd see enough of it to cut it in the side pocket, so I think he's forced to shoot the 1. Break that ball open. Did he break it up enough? Yes, he did. And he's got to shoot it. He's got no other shot. Can you run into the 9-ball here? I don't think so. I think he hits an 8-ball before he hits the 9-ball. So he might That's what I thought. That's what I thought. I says, I'm going to check that out. Can you make that ball? And the answer is yes, I can. And I can get shape on the... Ooh, maybe I can't get shape on. He's going to have to spin this in anyway. I don't think he wants to bank it in the lower right-hand corner. He's going to have to spin it. Kind of like that. Well done. Well, here's Ozzy's opportunity to run out. He's going to take a little break. Okay, we got Ozzy coming back into the arena. And it's his break. He leads 6-3 over Kevin Peterson. And this is just one on the one loss side, correct? How far along are they now? You haven't seen the bracket? Okay. This is a game on the one loss side, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier. Ozzy lost to Trace Kane. Trace Kane lost to Kevin Peterson. But I'm not sure who beat Kevin Peterson.
This is 5th-6.
This is actually for 5th-6. The winner continues to play. The loser is out in 5th-6. And According to Fargo, Ozzy has a 93% chance of winning this match, needing one game. Wow, Kevin needs three. Kevin has a 7% chance. He uses the side rail break and pockets it solid in the corner pocket. And the cue ball stops. He doesn't have squatto. He's got a bank on the three if he wants solids. And the solids are all open if he does take them. While the stripes are a little cluttered around the spot, to the left of the spot, even though the 10 and the 15 go, and the 12 goes, so they actually, whichever he takes, but his best shot is probably that bank shot. Could well be that the bank shot's the best shot. Looks like he might be able to cut that 9 ball into the lower left-hand corner, but he's going to travel that cue ball at a high rate of speed off of the 8. Well, he makes the bank shot, he wins the match. Is what I think. Doesn't mean much, but I made the bank shot. Shot on the 4, shot on the 6, with the 7 by the side pocket. All he really wants to do is get that 6. It leads him to the 1. Just fall forward just a hair. Right there. Now go 2 rails for either the 5 or the 4. I don't think it'll go all the way up for the 2. Nice and easy, nice and easy. Not too hard. There's an 11 ball over there, but if he gets behind the 11, he still has the 5. And even though things get complicated, he still has the 5. And roll up to that, get on the 4, then the deuce, and then come between the, try to leave the cue ball close to where the 13 is, just to the left for the 8 ball in the lower left-hand corner. He's seen where he has to be. Don't fall too far forward and get behind that 13 ball. Probably follow this to the rail and back out for the 2 in the same corner. He's going to want an angle to come straight down from where the 2 ball is, just a hair to the right to get on this 8 ball perfectly. Don't be straight in. He's pretty close to straight in. He's pretty close to straight in. This is tricky. Now see, that last step, you saw exactly, I can't go any further than this. He's just gonna stun it to the rail and come over to the right just a hair. Can't chance going past the 13. Well, you can if you're really, really accurate. You don't wanna go past there, because if you go too far, the 14 gets you. Where the 13 gets you. You have a small window. Actually, it's a big window, but it's easy to get stuck behind you, one or the other. Yeah, he can go all the way back there, yes. Right where he put his finger by the first diamond in the side pocket, he could go there. He has from the first to the second diamond from the side pocket, or all that side right there. It's delicate. It's a delicate. I think I'm going to go 2 rails into the 13. I'm going to follow this ball 2 rails right into the 13 instead of coming back. You're coming across the line of shape, but you're coming right into the 13 ball. This is for the match. He gets on the save ball. It's over. He's drawing the ball. Ouch. 13 ball. No, no. He can see it. He can see it. Long straight in. Long straight in. Kevin's got his hands up in here saying, oh, he can do it. He can do it, but this is one of the hardest shots in pool. Long straight in. It's the hardest shot in pool. This is one of my practice shots that I just roll in. I'd rather roll it than punch it. Looks like he'd rather fire it. Yep. Ouch, that was for the match. Ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. I guess he's going to want to take ball in hand and try to get ball in hand and do what he wants to with that eight ball. This is going to be a long game now. I think he's going to kick on this. He could play him safe here. He's going to kick to the head rail, come down and hit the hit. If he can hit the ball and the rail almost at the same time, he can trap him up right there. If his speed's perfect, he can really trap him up. Oh, it's not going to be a good hit. That was a split hit, which tie goes to the runner. There's no ball in hand. There's no discussion on that, so they both saw it good. Well, mission accomplished by Kevin, actually. He got that 11 ball opened up, and everything goes to this one corner pocket. He's going to pretend he's playing one pocket and probably play all four balls to that pocket. If you can get funny on these balls, he just did. Usually this match goes home in fifth, sixth position. The winner plays on the one loss side. Kevin needs to win three games. Ozzy needs to win one. Kevin's break. You don't want to break dry here. He's broke dry every time but once. Do or die for Kevin. He needs two games. Ozzy needs one. Things could tighten up here. Now there's only, if you can win this game, we're at Hill Hill. And what was a comfortable lead can turn into a pressure situation for both players. Well, it's been pressure for Kevin the whole way. A little more pressure for, almost lost on the side, but he didn't. Open table. Smacked him great. One ball tied up. Everything else is open. There's five stripes left on the table and six solids. 14's tying up the eight ball. How do you open it up? I like to take stripes here and figure out how to open up that 14. He could do it right here with a draw shot, but he's going to take solids. The open shot is better than ball's not tied up. I don't like moving balls. I could have easily moved to a position where it, blocked one of his balls and get to have a trouble ball again. I thought the five ball went by it, but apparently maybe it didn't. That's why I moved it. That one ball's a little tight. He's going to have to maneuver fairly well to get good shape on it. Don't clip this. He did. And now he's tied up another ball. But he's got an angle to get to it right now. He can use a little bit of left low English or center low English and come over and get between the 11 and the 2. Or move the 11 and have a shot on the 2. He's got a good angle, so not a problem. And he's banking the ball. Good shot. Not sure if that eight ball, he's looking at the eight ball now. Will it go on the side? Apparently it will. He's one of these guys that's right-handed. I have him left-handed, so that shot lines up pretty nice for me. Not so nice for him. Every inch is money. The further he goes up, the more he's forced to shoot the seven ball. Now, question. Do you kill this with left English and get on the 3? Or do you put right English on the ball and try to open up the 8? Well, we got too many obstacles to try to open up the 8, so I'm going to have to kill this ball with left English. Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi. I have to say he was a little fortunate there. Could have easily bumped at 11 and got behind the 14, the 15 ball. Now he still has to get, he's trying to see where he has to be for this 8 ball. Interesting. Interesting. He's going to go to the left corner pocket and go 2 rails, 3 rails at the 8. Good scratch on the side. Well, now it's up to Ozzy. Do I want to go hill-hill? Possibly hill-hill? Oh, yeah. Do I want to go hill, or do I want to just win the match here? I'm going to shoot this 15 ball in the corner pocket. Get a good angle for the ball up by the rail, or a good angle on the 11 to break out that 14. And right here, he's going to try to break out the 14. Nope, he's going to shoot that ball first. He's a little too steep of an angle to try to break out the 14. Can he play safe behind the 8? Dangerous. You don't get it, you lose. You know what he could do here? Is he could shoot this 12 ball. You come over close to the 14. You can shoot the 12 ball and come right into the 14. Just don't be on the left, on the upside of it, because the 8 ball's there and you could scratch. Okay. Now pocket the 10 and come into the 14. Or will he go back and forth? All he has to do is tap it. And I like the way he'll be coming in if he shoots this 10 ball. But he's got to hit it pretty hard, so that's not going to work. To be sure of what he's doing here. Not a time to guess and take a shot where you say to yourself, I think I can get there. I think I try to break it out right here. And if I didn't, I'll do something with the 10 and try to leave the cue ball behind the 8-14. So, in essence, if your cue ball control is good enough, and Ozzy's is, you have a free shot of breaking it out. If he hits a 14 square, he's straight in on the 10, and he'll be straight in on the 14 for the side. Now, there is a possibility. Kevin's almost straight in. He's going to come down and try to get close to where he is now for the 8 ball on the side, I believe. He thinks he looked at it earlier and he felt he could make it there. He's called it in the side. No problem. We're at hill-hill, guys. What turned out to look like a runaway match turn into a nail biter. But as I said earlier, Ozzy will have the break. He broke and ran out the first two racks that he broke. So, if you can repeat that pattern, it's game over. If you can't, it's time to maybe duck. Cue ball. There was a ball on the break. It's open. He only has one shot. The ball right next to the cue ball, the 15 ball in the side pocket. Everything, all except one ball are on the left side of the table. Open table, made one of each. There's six stripes left, there's six solids left. This ball to the side. His only other shot is probably going to be the 9 ball or the 12 that's way up by the deuce in the left-hand corner up on top. It's the only other shot. But he's got nice position on the 9, followed by the 11. He can get out right here. This is open. This isn't clustered. 11 ball goes on the side. He can play that right now. After the 9, he can play the 11 on the side. And the 14 and the 12. Get on the 13 straight in and then just stop it for the 8 in the corner. Pocket the ball. Nice, nice, nice. 11 on the side. Get out. Well, actually, he doesn't have to get out. He can just come back a little bit, and from there, he can pocket the 13 and slowly push the 8 ball towards the right-hand corner pocket and be straight in on that. To make sure he hits this ball where he doesn't get underneath it and end up with a bank shot. It's a little bit of draw. Just make the ball. And there it is. Kevin Peterson. Congratulations to Kevin Peterson for a 5th-6th finish. He just wanted to make it a nail biter. He just didn't want to run away with it, did he? Steven?